So once again I'm back children with one more value. So you have seen the videos. Two values we have seen the videos. First one was obedience. Second one was about honesty. And I told you in the beginning, first class, you know what is the subject, that is value education. In this value education, we are going to learn some of the moral values. These moral values are very important for all the living beings, all the human beings. We need to follow these moral values so that we will be a successful person, will be a good person, and we will cultivate the good habits in our life to be successful, so that our life should go smoothly, no? So we need to follow these moral values. So these moral values are very important in our life. So you need to inculcate these moral values in your day-to-day life. So you have learnt about obedience. Are you obeying the parents? Yes. Good children, you all are obeying the parents. Second one was about honesty. No? Are you a honest person? Are you honest? Yes. You are very honest children. We know you are very good children. Okay? You develop this moral values in your life. So today we are going to learn one more moral value, that is discipline. D-I-S-C-I-P-I-L-I-N-E. This discipline. So we learn about this discipline. It is very important for all the human beings to be well disciplined in our life. So first we'll understand the meaning of this discipline. What is discipline? As I told you, in English language, this one word will be having many meanings. Several meanings are there. So, according to the moral values, we'll see what is the meaning of discipline. So, discipline is a set of rules. So, it is a set of rules regulating behavior. So, we human beings, we have different behaviors in different situations, right? So, this discipline, it is one of the value which is having a set of rules regulating our behavior. It is related to our behavior. So, we need, you know, certain behaviors are there in us. We have good behaviors and bad behaviors. Sometimes we behave very well, very well mannered. Sometimes we behave very badly, we behave rudely. So, we need to discipline ourselves by following some of the rules. Who has given these rules for you? Yes, it will. These rules are from our spiritual books. We are learning these rules from our spiritual books. Sometimes we learn these rules from our elders. They tell us some stories. So many great personalities are there. They have followed the rules. They have set the rules through the holy scriptures, through the holy books, and they have shaped their life. So same way children, these rules are followed from the holy scriptures. You need to read the holy books. As I told you all, every day you need to pray, no? Along with the prayer, whichever holy book is related to your religion, you need to read it. You need to read. It is very important. It is very essential along with your studies. You need to read the holy books of your religion and understand those scriptures. Whatever scriptures is written in the holy book, you need to understand. And not only understanding, you need to follow it so that your life will be blessed life. So that your life will be blessed life. Through these holy books, holy scriptures, you will be blessed. In all the religions, in Christians, Muslims, Hindus, all the religions are having their own holy books. So read, children. Practice the holy shlokas, verses. So in the Muslim people, you see, they regularly they read the holy book, that is Quran. Right from the childhood, they practice the Quran, reading of Quran. And they feel happy. Every day they have the classes. So make it a point in your life, everybody, not only Muslims, Christians are there, Hindus are there. You have seen your grandparents early morning when they wake up, what they do? They take bath, they do the pujas, they read the shlokas, they read the vachanas, no? So you also learn from them, learn from your elders. So you learn so many things, right? You learn to read, right? Same way you need to learn these moral values through the holy books. So first you understood about discipline. It is the rules. Rules. Who made these rules? Not government. We ourselves. By reading the holy scriptures and by following our ancestors, elders. We see them and we follow the rules. Many people, till now I can see the grandparents, they have a well-disciplined life. They wake up early morning at 5 o'clock. They do their regular activities along with the prayers and all. You can see their life is so disciplined. They do the work time to time. So same way, as a student, you need to practice this. So in this discipline, we have two types. In this discipline, we have two types. One is internal and external. So you can see, children, in our life, we can discipline ourselves. One is internal discipline. And another one is external. So there are two types. One is internal discipline and external discipline. So to understand better, to understand this better, that is about these two types of discipline, we'll watch one story. It is a story of Chanakya. He was a great personality. Maybe you have read in the books. I'll be showing you the story. Watch the story carefully. Then we'll come back again to the class. Are you all ready, children? Okay, watch the story.
Tell you a new moral story. Discipline and self-control. A story about the king Chandragupta and his advisor Chanakya. Let us begin with the story. Chandragupta was a popular emperor in Indian history. Chanakya was a royal advisor to the king. He was also a philosopher and political scientist. He has authored Arthashastra, the Indian book on politics. Once during the cabinet meeting of ministers, Chanakya said to the king, "Your Majesty, most of our people are suffering from severe poverty. They suffer a lot due to biting cold in the winter season. Therefore, you could freely provide them with woolen blankets." The king immediately accepted Chanakya's request and promised to provide the poor people with woolen blankets freely. Further, I appoint you, Chanakya, as the person in charge of distributing the blankets to the poor, ordered the king and sent bundles of blankets to the house of Chanakya. Knowing this order, and scheme secretly, some robbers planned to steal the woolen blankets, sell them and earn money. Accordingly, they entered into the house of Chanakya in the midnight. They saw the bundles of blankets stored in the house. They also witnessed Chanakya and his mother sleeping with old and torn blankets. The robbers were surprised at this sight. Leaving the idea of stealing, they woke up sleeping Chanakya and his mother. Chanakya was shocked to see them. The robbers said to him, "Sir, we are robbers. We came here to steal these new and good woolen blankets. But we were surprised to see you and your mother sleeping with old and torn blankets. Why did you not use these new woolen blankets?" Chanakya replied to them, "These blankets are meant only for the poor people. I will not take them for my personal use. I cannot betray my king who has entrusted me with the duty of distributing them to the poor." Hearing this explanation, the robbers were moved and fell at the feet of the Chanakya. And they said, "Forgive us, sir. Hereafter we won't steal others' properties. This is our oath." Children, now tell me, what do we learn from this story? The self-disciplined people alone can be sincere and honest in public life. Society will respect and honor the person who are self-disciplined, honest and sincere. Such person will be successful in life. With most self-disciplined, anything is possible, says Roosevelt. Self-discipline is a human value. It is more than keeping rules and regulations. Therefore, internal discipline shapes one's personality. And external discipline reveals one's personality. Some examples for discipline are rising early in the morning, doing the homework given, keeping punctuality in school, communicating with all in good manners, listening to the class attentively, playing in the evening, helping my parents. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Thanks for watching.
So, how was the story, children? Did you all like the story? Yes. What did you see in that story? Yes, there was a person, no? He was Chanakya. He was given the duty of distributing the blankets to the needy ones. So when he was given this duty, some of the robbers came to know that he is going to distribute this blankets. So these robbers thought they will rob those blankets and earn money. By seeing Chanakya and his mother, the robbers, they were completely surprised. They were thinking, see, he got such a good blankets, then too he is not using it. So then they decided not to rob. So see, children, how they have changed, no? By seeing the discipline of Chanakya. He has developed, he is a well-disciplined person. He had some self-discipline in him. So self-discipline, people alone can be sincere and honest in public life. Seen that story, have seen, no? How self-disciplined he was. He did not use the blankets. He would have used those blankets for his personal use, but he did not use. But See children, when we are self-disciplined, we will be sincere. We can be sincere and honest in the public life. Society will respect and honor such person. Those who are self-disciplined, society will respect them. They won't talk unnecessary things about them. They will be respecting and honoring them. So, and this self-disciplined, honest person, they are sincere and they will be very successful in their life. You can see many great leaders, they had their own discipline, their self-discipline, and they have achieved so many things in their life. So you people also, as a student, you need to be self-disciplined. With this most self-discipline, anything is possible, says the Roosevelt. One of the great author, he tells that with most self-discipline, anything is possible. See, when we follow this discipline in our life, as a student, what are the discipline you can follow? So many things are there in your day-to-day life. So that comes under the internal discipline. External discipline is to show the society. But internal discipline, as a student, to be a successful person, things are rising early in the morning. This is your duty, no? As a good person, you can rise up early in the morning. Discipline is one of the most important thing in every student's life. You students must learn the discipline because that is necessary to be successful in your life. See, when you rise up early in the morning, it will be very helpful for you. You can be a very successful person. Discipline in school life is important for all the students, not only in the house, at house, in the school also. You can be a disciplined person. A disciplined person need for a good functioning of the society. Discipline is needed in every life. If you are a disciplined person, if you know some of the disciplines, then you can be a good person in the society. Then your life will function properly. What are some disciplines that you can follow as a student? Let us listen, okay children? First one is, I told you, rising early in the morning. Are you all doing nowadays? Yes, very late, no? Nowadays, due to this lockdown, you are going to bed late and you are rising late in the morning. But follow children, you rise early in the morning in the fresh air, fresh mind. You can learn so many things. You can do the work actively. Not only your studies, you will be active whole day. Then second one is doing the homework given. Are you all writing the notes? We are sending the notes. We are asking you to write in the CW. We are asking you to learn. So as a student, it is necessary. It is one of the discipline, that is doing the homework given. Keeping punctuality in school. Now you may tell that, Miss, no school, how can we keep the punctuality? You can keep the punctuality in your class. You watch the classes regularly, punctually. Daily you maintain the timing. If your parents are working parents, you can maintain one time. You can maintain the time. As your parents come home, you can ask them the mobile. You can maintain the same timing every day. And you can maintain the time for study. You should maintain the time for having your meals. Nowadays, because of this pandemic, you all are not following the timings for your meals. Breakfast is at 11 o'clock. Lunch is at 4 o'clock. Dinner at 11 o'clock. Is it right, children? No. You need to follow. So, keeping punctuality in your daily routine. Okay? So that you will be healthy So eat well, time to time, maintain the timing so that you will not have any health issues or health problem. Nowadays you all are getting so many health issues. Your stomach is upset, you are not healthy because you are not following the discipline in your eating habits. Then communicate all with good manners. So when you are talking, when you want to tell something, you communicate with a good manners. You see that you will not use bad words, you don't use the rash words, right? You don't speak in a rude manner. Sometimes we behave badly, you know, with the parents, with the elders, we behave rashly because of our mood, because of our situations. Sometimes it happens, but you see that, try to control, try to behave properly, since discipline is regulating our behavior. You try. As a human being, we all make this mistake, but we should try. Then communicating with good manners. Listening to the class attentively. See children, nowadays what you are doing? On the mobile, keep the video on and be somewhere. You are not attentive in the class, watching the classes. When you come to class, we ask you, sometimes we call out your names, we tell, oh, you are not attentive, where are you looking? So you need to be attentive in listening your classes. See, only when you listen attentively to the teachers, what they are telling, then you can study well. Or else you tell, I don't know miss, what miss told, I don't know. Your parents, when they ask you, you give them the answer like this. Then you tell, oh miss did not tell that. You give all these excuses. So listen to the class attentively. Playing in the evening. See, many times what happened? All the time children are playing nowadays. Parents are complaining. They are not having their meals. They are not having their lunch. They are not having their dinner. But always they are playing. We don't know but what you all are playing. Play in the evening. Especially you need to play physical games. Not your mental games. That is your video games and your playing online games. This will not help you children. That is only for pleasure. But when you play physically, when you go out of your house, play in the evening, then you see your health will improve. You'll come to know what is around you and how to handle the situations. No? So maintain a discipline of playing in the evening. Always don't be very playful. You all are growing up. Day by day, you are becoming older. Only game is not important. Your studies are important. You need to build up your personal life, personality. So, play in the evening. Helping parents. Are you all helping? You are helping your parents? Yes, I know some of the children, they are very good. They help the parents for cutting the vegetables, for cooking. Sometimes some children, they will help in keeping the house neat, sweeping, swabbing. It's very good, children. Help your parents. If you are not helping your parents, try to do it. It is very important. You need to be helpful. Okay, children? You need to be helpful to your parents. So, when you follow the discipline, there are some benefits. When you follow the discipline, there are benefits. It is not loss in your life. There are benefits. What are the benefits? As a student, it is important of discipline in student life, you can attract all the right things. You will be doing the right things. Then students can gain success in each field of their life. Not only studies, not only in the workplace, at home, in the society, you will be very successful person. So you need to follow the discipline in your life. So therefore, the importance of discipline in life cannot be ignored. If you ignore the discipline, then your life will not be successful. If you don't follow the discipline, you cannot be a successful person. So children, you need, as a student, you follow these disciplines. There are many disciplines that you can follow in your life. When you are at home, you can discipline yourself by doing some work, good work, not bad work, good work. Keep a timetable for your studies. Don't waste your time. You can maintain that timetable. You can maintain that timetable and study well. So when you have discipline in your life, you can make small sacrifice. If you sacrifice little things now, you'll have a better future. So it says that when you have discipline in your life, you can make small sacrifice in the present for a better life in the future. So now if you go on sleeping, what happens? Can you be a successful person? No. So sacrifice, little things you sacrifice. So discipline creates habits, habits makes routine, and routines become who you are daily. So remember children, I want to tell you one thing, that is, this is very important. Discipline creates habits, habits makes routines, and routines become who you are daily. So children, I hope you all understood about discipline. So be a well-disciplined person. You need to build up your internal discipline and external discipline. Internal discipline will help you to shape one's personality so that you can shape your personality well. External discipline, it reveals your personality. What type of person you are, it will reveal. So first, as a student, you need to develop the internal discipline in your life. So I would like to tell you one quote and end this class. Okay, children? Life without discipline is just like a shape without ladder. So always remember this quote. Life without discipline is just like a shape without ladder. So try to follow this value, that is discipline, and build up your personality. Okay, children? See you in the next class with one more new moral value. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. See you, children.